Welcome to this fourth video of quadratic equations. In this video, we are going to see what is the solution of quadratic equation by factorization method. Before, in this previous video, we have seen if the given value of the variable is root or solution or not. But finding the root or solution of given quadratic equation by the trial and error method is a very tedious job. So we should know how to find the solution, and for this we have selected the first factorization method. Now, already you have studied in previous classes how to find factors of quadratic polynomials, that also trinomial. Let's recall this and then we will find what is the solution of the quadratic equation. Now I have selected four equations with all the varieties. Now what is this first equation, x square plus equation of polynomial, x square plus 7x plus 12. This is a trinomial in one variable x, highest power is 2, so it is quadratic polynomial. Now if we compare with this ax square plus bx plus c, what we will do, we will try to write the factors of this c, which is 12. Okay. Now what are the factors of 12? Factors of 12 are 12 ones are 12 or 12 ones are or 1 12 are. If you have 2 cuttable, 6 2s are 12, 2 6s are, 2 6s are. If it is 3 4s are, 4 3s are or 3 4s are 12. So these are the three types of factors of 12. Now which factors we have to select? Now for this we have to concentrate on the sign of 12. What is the sign of 12? When the sign of c is plus, we should select such factors where the addition of the factor is equal to 7. So when it is plus 12, we have to factorize 12 in such a way that addition of the factor should be 12. So here if you see, what is the addition? 12 and 1, if you add this 12 plus 1, the addition is going to be 13. Here the addition is what? 6 plus 2, it is 8. Here what is the addition? 4 and 3, 4 plus 3 is 7. Now what do you want addition? You want the addition equal to the middle term or B factor. So if you want the addition to be 7, you need to check this 7. So you have to select the factors of 12 is 4 and 3. Means product of 4 and 3 is 12 and sum of 4 and 3 is 7. So 4 into 3 is 12 and 4 plus 3 is equal to 7. Now here this sign of 7 is plus. So if we want addition plus 7, this should both should be plus. Correct. So now we got these values or factors of 12, plus 4 and plus 3. We will utilize this to factorize here. How? We will write x square first term as it is. We will write the second term 7x in the splitted form, attack or multiplying these factors by x, because this is x, 7x we want. This is 7x. So we will write plus 4x plus 3x. So addition of this two terms is 7x and plus 12 as it is. So we have splitted the middle term 7x to get the proper factors of this. So here if we write for from common from this, x is common and we will get x plus 4 in this remaining uncommon, and from these two plus 3 is common, correct? And then uncommon is what? X plus 3 4s are 12. Now as we got this bracket common, the final factors we got this common is x plus 4 in one bracket and the other bracket is x plus 3. So these are the two factors of this trinomial, given trinomial. Okay. Now let's see how to factorize this x square minus 7x plus 12. If you observe, I have taken similar trinomial, only the sign of plus 7x, here it is minus 7x. So here also, as this 12 is having plus sign, we should select such factors of 12 where the addition gives you 7. Now again here also, for this plus 12, factors are 4, 3s are 12, where the addition is 7. But now here we don't want addition plus 7, we want it minus 7. So here the sign should be minus 4, minus 3. Hence, the product of minus 4 and minus 3 is going to be plus 12. But the sum of minus 4 and minus 3 is going to be minus 7. So 4 and 3 we are going to take same, as we want addition of factors of 12 to be 7 and the sum is minus, so we have given this minus signs. So here you will write x square minus 4x minus 3x plus 12. Now from this 2 and this 2 we will make a group. We will take x common, remaining is what? X minus 4. Now I will give you clue what is to be taken from the next 2. Copy the same bracket whichever you have written here. X minus 4. Now when you have written x minus 4, this is a smart tip for you. You will not go wrong if you follow this thing. Now from this third term, what you have written here? X. Okay. So what is remaining here? Minus 3. So write minus 3. This is common from both. So how you can check? Take the product of this. X minus 3 into x minus 3x. Minus 3 into minus 4 is what? Plus 12. You can check it here also. X into x, x square. X into minus 4 is minus 4. So this is a smart tip for you. How to get this common from these two. Instead of writing minus 3, copy the same bracket and then write this term. Automatically you will get your correct answer. Okay. Now x minus 4 is the common in this both. Write x minus 4 and remaining uncommon is x minus 3. So these are the two factors of given this trinomial. Correct. Now another situation we have faced that all this we are recalling because all these are important for us to solve practice set 2.2. How to solve the quadratic equation. You have to do all these things in that solution also. So we are just recalling this. Okay. Now when the it is third equation polynomial is here x square plus 4x minus 12. Now here the sign of 12 is not minus. So what we have to do, now we have to select such factors of 12 where the subtraction will give you the middle number 4. So let's check here subtraction. What is subtraction of 12 and 1? 12 minus 1 is going to be 11. What is subtraction of 6 and 2? 6 minus 2 is going to be 4. What we want? We want 4 only, correct? So we need to check, take these factors from these 3 available factors. So when the last term is minus 12 and here we have 1 as a coefficient of x square everywhere. So if it is minus 12, so 12 ka factor should be such that the subtraction should be 4. And we have seen that 4 and 2, subtraction of 4 and 2 is 6 and 2 is 4. So we will take 6 2s are 4 and this addition of this, this sign is plus 4. So this sign should be given to the greater factor. Plus sign, give it to greater, plus 6. And its opposite, give it to smaller. Means opposite of plus is minus. Verify this. If you take the product of 6 into minus 2, it is minus 12. And the sum of this 2 is going to be plus 4. Correct? So we have got such factor where the addition is plus 4 and product is minus 12. Now we can factorize in the same way x square plus 6x, don't forget to write the variable here, minus 2x minus 12. And writing this, taking this common from these two, x common, remaining is x plus 6. Now from here what is common? Use my trick, students write, have some distance and copy this x plus 6 here. Okay. So, out of this third term minus 2x, you have written x. What is remaining here? It's minus 2. So this is the common. And you can say x plus 6 is common and uncommon bracket is x minus 2. Okay. And for the last, this x square minus 4x minus 12. Again, here the sign of 12 is minus and we want subtraction of factors to be 4. But here the 4 is not plus, it is minus. So now, here in this case, what we will do, we will take factors of 12 such that 6 2s are 12 where the subtraction is 4. But as now, this middle term is negative, this sign should be given to the bigger number or greater factor. So 6 should be now minus and 2 should be its opposite plus. So we will factorize this as x square minus 6x plus 2x minus 12. Take common from first two terms x in bracket x minus 6. Use my trick. Write this same bracket here x minus 6 by leaving some space over here. This is common bracket. See the third term. It is plus 2x. Out of plus 2x we have written x. So remaining is plus 2. So the factors of this is x minus 6 and x plus 2. So this we have studied in previous class 8. And now which we are going to apply for the solution of quadratic equation. Now these were quadratic polynomial. If we write the same polynomial here, x square plus 7x plus 2 if I write is equal to 0, this polynomial get converted into quadratic equation. Now we can write all this thing here. Now as we have already done over here, I am not repeating the same process here. I will write the factors of this. So what is the factors of this? These are the factors, okay, of given trinomial. So if I copy it here, x plus 4 and x plus 3, which are the factors of this trinomial, is equal to 0. Okay, so till this much you have studied in previous class. What extra we are doing in class 10? We are getting the factors of trinomial. These are factors we got. Now here I have written directly factors, but actually you should do all this process. Okay, so if these are the factors, so product of this is equal to 0, what does it mean? Either this term should be 0 or this bracket should be 0. So after this we will write, so either x plus 4 is equal to 0 or x plus 3 is equal to 0. If x plus 4 is 0, then what will happen? So x will become that 4 going on that side, it will become 0 minus 4 and therefore x is equal to minus 4. Okay. And here x plus 3 is equal to 0, then x is equal to 0 minus 3 and therefore x is equal to minus 3. You can skip this step and you can go directly for this step after this. So whatever your factors you have got, so are both product of this 0. So either one of these should be 0. So your final answer will be minus 4 and minus 3 are the roots of given quadratic equation, or you can write that equation x square plus 7x plus 12 is equal to 0. My dear students, when your quadratic equation highest power is 2, generally you should get 2 roots. Generally, sometimes you may get 1 also. We will learn more about this in the next video when we will solve from sums from practice set 2.2. I hope you have understood what is the difference between quadratic polynomial and quadratic equation and how to get solution of quadratic equation. Thank you. If you like this video, don't forget to like, give me comments also, forward this to your friends, and if you have not yet subscribed, please subscribe the channel. Thank you very much.